This is former Indiana basketball player Brian Evans, and you're listening to Indiana Sports Beat with Jim Coyle.
Today's guest is brought to you by Reynolds Family Dentistry of Sellersburg. You need a $1 million smile for those championship photos, and that's exactly what you'll get with Reynolds Family Dentistry. Welcome back, Indiana Sports Beat with Coyle Leary, coming to you live from the foul course at Indiana University today on this unbelievable, beautiful Tuesday, and cannot be any more appropriate to have the biggest name in the history of Indiana golf, Jeff Overton, joining us. Jeff, thank you so much, man, for taking time to be with us.
Absolutely, yeah.
How are things going in Florida? I know you're down in Florida. Have you seen the course yet at all?
You know, whenever I got the chance last year to come back and kind of drive around it and see it, and what a beautiful spot. Fuzzy, Ned, Smyers, Spider Miller, a lot of big names down there in southern Indiana all were huge people involved in building this kind of a dream golf course, and it's just amazing that they were able to get it done, and it's super exciting. I've talked to a lot of people. There's a lot of people excited to, now that it's open, to get down, get up and play it, and it's awesome. It's going to do nothing but help recruiting out for Coach Mayer, and I'm super stoked about it.
A little bit nicer than the course you played on, huh?
Yeah, that was going to be my next question, Jeff, was as a player, like, how big of a factor is it? I mean, we know Purdue's course is obviously really nice, and Ohio State's is really nice. How big a factor is the actual golf course in making your decision where to go as a recruited golfer?
You know, I think that there's a lot of deciphering aspects, if you were to say, as far as when you're recruiting on where to go to school. You know, obviously, the better the facilities, the more opportunity you have. And when you're talking about the big-time college athletics at a Big Ten university, it's nice to, you know, you think about the IU course being right there, you know, walking distance basically from dorms along with Assembly Hall. Like, there's really not too many universities that have the overall, all the sports, you know, right there in that little same complex, super close, you know, because people, you know, when you're going to class, you know, you got classes first, then the school's next, and it's nice whenever you only have to drive, you know, 5 minutes away to go to the golf course to get your practice in versus some place you might have to go 30-45 minutes. And then, you know, you think about, like, the in-state kids that are really, you know, generally speaking, if you're kind of in the Midwest, it's the type of, you know, people that you're used to, and being close to home, and it's such a big, I guess you could say, it's just a big change when you go from high school to college, and it's kind of nice that you have such an awesome golf course, and then the practice facility. If you're one of those top recruits, it's hard to, and you're from Indiana, it'd be hard to not want to go to school there with this golf course.
Yeah, it's such a beautiful layout. As I'm sitting here looking out upon it, I'm kind of jealous that I have to sit here and go out. But I remember playing on it when I was back in the day, and I can't imagine it. The difference this thing must make. But how are things going with you? I know you're down in Florida trying to get back into swing of everything, but how's life going?
Life's going. I've been struggling with back, and just been doing a lot of exercises trying to get the thing healthy enough to swing again. It's just been a tough little battle, but needless to say, it's whatever. Hopefully one day we'll get healthy enough to maybe we'll be able to be competitive again is the dream. But it's hard to still hard to kind of bend over, so I haven't really been able to do much practicing and stuff, unfortunately.
Have you had the opportunity over the winter? I know you dealt with the health issues and that stuff. Have you had the opportunity to come back and go to a basketball game? I know I saw some pictures, but I think that was from a few years ago. Do you make it back to Indiana very often?
I was able to come back. I usually get back there once or twice a year. I was able to come back, you know, for a couple of years. Yeah, I've been able to make it back there a little bit, but not as much as if I was able to be golfing. You know, I'd definitely be back there taking advantage of that new golf course and facilities and what have you a little bit. working with Coach Mayer and all that good stuff, like the old days. But and hopefully one of these days it'll happen. It's just, it's whatever reason, it's just timing's not on my side at this moment for golf. But I'm definitely working my tail end off, if you could say, to get back. It's just, it hasn't, haven't been able to quite get out of pain all the way yet. So.
You're always with us in spirit, because we do last year we did the IU basketball postgame show from Yogi's, and your golf bag was hanging over us every show we did. There's your golf bag hanging above us.
Good old Yogi's. There's nothing like Bloomington. So many good spots. I guess Yogi's is gone now, but man, there's a lot of history there in Bloomington, and what a great little what a great town that is.
Obviously, Yogi's has resurfaced, actually. There's a new location downtown. So that's what I meant. Your golf ball's in the new in the new Yogi's. So we stared at that every game last year.
Man, it has been a while since I've been back there.
What's the plan with the game? I know you talk about dealing with the health issues, and it's so important. And we hear that a lot with golfers, the back issue, man. It's such a big part, obviously, when you're swinging all that time. But, man, is that so crucial and something you have to get past, especially at this age. What's the plan?
Yeah, I don't know. It's just, you know, I'm just lucky to be alive. When you get an infection in your spine, it's not good. And I'm just glad I can walk there for a while. I've been through a lot. I just continue to grind it out and keep doing some of these exercises and keep researching some of the spine stuff. And it's definitely a tough thing to, I guess, overcome, getting an infection in the bone in your back. And it's tough. So I don't know, but I'm excited about the new golf course there, and just try to make light on the situation and just move forward. And, you know, I don't know what's going to be next or how long it's going to take.
As a professional golfer, obviously golf coming back last weekend you know, what would the biggest differences be, or would it be a huge difference in not having the fans on the course? I know in watching it, it made a bit of a difference, but I kind of got used to it. And after a while, I don't even think I really noticed it. As a player, how much different would that be, and would it be a huge factor for you?
You know, I think probably not having fans in other sports would probably impact it more. I mean, yeah, you look at like home court advantage and college basketball and college football and NFL, and, you know, the whole, you ride that momentum, all the good vibes from the crowd. And, you know, whereas golf, it's a little more of an individual game, and you have a lot of people that are cheering for different people, but they're really usually cheering for great shots. And I guess you have some guys, maybe it would affect a little more than others. And it's, you know, I guess golf is, to me, has always been kind of a game. You get outside and you're in harmony with the environment. And whenever you have more people, you know, obviously there's more things that you have to adapt to. Whereas if there's no fans, you know, you just are, you're out there playing your game, and maybe it's a little easier to not think about, like, some of the things just that might get in people's way, I guess. You have the fans yelling for one guy, or like if there's a big Tiger crowd or Phil crowd, you know, you might have a big group of people that are really wanting to watch those guys versus, you know, others. And I definitely think it can affect some people more than others, but I think that all around, it's a good thing that people are able to see some kind of a live action sport on TV, because there is, you know, as far as viewers go, there's more people watching it probably on television, generally speaking, week in, week out, than there is that actually show up to the events. However, it is an unfortunate thing, because, as you know, the tour raises a whole bunch of charity dollars, and by not being able to have the people and the fans out there to give them that awesome on-course environment, it's tough. I don't. So it's hopefully eventually they'll be able to get fans back in it, and life will move back onwards how it was moving before. And but right now, in this tough little time, it's probably good to just keep everybody kind of quarantined, per se, a little bit.
Yeah, that's where we're pretty much left at now, and hopefully you can improve your golf game or whatever you're trying to do if you're at home trying to get through this. But, yeah, Jeff, I cannot thank you enough for taking time to join us here on today, and we wish you the best as you rehab and get back into things, because everybody wants to see you back on the course, man.
Well, I appreciate it. I do, too.
I bet. No one more. Jeff Overton joining us today from Florida. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. Thanks.
This is Jim Coyle from Indiana Sports Beat with Coyle and Leary. Indiana Sports Beat is now a part of the Rivals Network. You can go to thehoosier.com to sign up. It's free. Catch the show there each day live or at your convenience. You can also like or follow us on Facebook, follow the show's rebroadcast, anywhere you podcast. If we're not on a radio station where you live, we should be. Let your local station know they need to carry Indiana Sports Beat with Coyle Leary, or simply go to thehoosier.com.